Chuck Reagan ist jetzt hier bei mir. Viele kennen ihn noch von Hot Water Music. Heute spielt er mit seinem Solo-Projekt und Band hier beim Family First Festival. So Chuck, are you looking forward playing tonight? Is it a special show for you?
Very much so. It's always a pleasure to be back in the city and we're meeting up with some old friends that we haven't seen in a long time and it's going to be a very special show. I heard that it sold out really quickly, maybe 3 weeks or something, and people are very excited, we're excited, and just happy to be here. So
do you remember your first gig with Hot Water Music in Germany? I think it was in Frankfurt, near Frankfurt, in 1998, and you played in front of like 80 people, but you really had a good time there, yeah?
Yeah, I'll never forget it. It was actually in a small little town called Rosvine. We played at the youth house. We were picked up by a couple different friends from the airport, picked up in Frankfurt, and we went straight to Rosvine. And it was our very first impression of Europe. It was our first impression of traveling abroad as young men. And for us to kind of, basically begin our life on the road overseas in that little town, I feel in many ways kind of defined what the band was all about and who we were and it's also part of the reason why I feel like we've always had such a special connection with people of Germany and fans of Germany. It was a beautiful first impression. You're right, it was a really small show in this youth house and people were just extremely hospitable, and in fact there's still one of the guys traveling with us is the guy who put on that show. He's one of my best friends and we still travel together every time I tour here. So
and what does the audience gives you?
Oh, many things. many things. I mean, I feel really lucky to be in a position to have been able to do something that I love for so many years. And I am very well aware and I respect the fact that that would have not be possible if it wasn't for the people, if it wasn't for the audience. So one of the things that the audience gives me is this life, this career, this ability to travel around the world and play music. It's a very special privilege. It's not something that I feel like I've earned or something. You know, anyone who's done anything for a number of years, everyone pays their dues, yes. You know, we all pay our dues. We all make mistakes. We go through things that help us learn and become better human beings. But I feel, you know, it doesn't matter what we've done in the past. What matters most is what we're doing today and what we aim to do in the future. And, you know, to me, like, it's not necessarily something that I've earned the right to be here. It's more of a privilege and an honor, so.
I saw you years ago with Muff Potter, yeah. in Cologne. Sure. Do you have a special connection or relation to the German punk and hardcore scene?
Sure, I mean, part of it was, yeah, the very first tour that we did, we worked with a lot of friends through Green Hell. Burkhardt and Timo, who we still work with today, and Green Hell was kind of like almost like a sister label to No Idea Records, which was our home label in Gainesville, Florida, Hot Waters. So I feel like the very first tour that we did over here, I want to say Forever and Counting was the record that we first came over. I could be wrong, my memory, but you know, I think there was a correlation. There was kind of a like-minded mentality, you know, between the record labels and a lot of the bands. And it was just where we felt at home. It was where we felt the most comfortable.
But touring is kind of a family gathering for you, isn't it?
Sure, yeah, it has to be. If you're living with someone on the road in a bus, you want to make sure that you love them because, yeah, you get to know someone really quickly, you know, when you're spending day in and day out with them, yeah.
So your life changed in the last years, and would you say you're less restless now?
Sure. I mean, I've been less restless for a long time, you know, ever since I fell in love, you know, but yeah, life is always changing. The biggest change lately is I'm now a daddy. I just had, my wife and I had our first baby boy, Grady Joseph, he just is about to turn 3 months old. So he's a brand new baby boy, and he's a good boy, and it's tough. It's tough being away, you know, and I don't know how much I'll be away from him, you know, anymore.
And how did touring and the life on tour change for you in the last years?
I mean, it's definitely changed quite a bit. I seem to tour less and less, which to me is a good thing. In many ways, I think that it's important to always have diversity in your life, even in your work. I love playing music. I love visiting people. I love being a part of these music communities. But if you do something day in and day out, anything can become old or stagnant. You can kind of forget how special things are if it's something that you're repeating all the time. So to me, you know, slowing down in many ways is just making it better, you know, making it more positive.
You're very attached to nature. Do you miss it while being on tour?
Always, yeah. But we somehow still find it anywhere we go, you know. Yeah, of course. You know, I'm not a religious man per se, but you know, I do find a peace. I find I guess my own spirituality in a sense in the woods or on the water. So, you know, it's a constant connection that's always been with me and most likely will always be. So
would you say that moments are getting more sacred when you grow older?
Yeah, I do. Because, you know, I feel the older we get, the more we realize how short life is. You know, you tend to appreciate what you have a little bit more.
And you will be on stage with Boy Sets Fire tonight, right?
I'm going to give it a shot, yeah. Yeah, they asked me just today, so... yeah, I'll do my best.